So probably just pull up. Hey,
it's recording.
All right, hey, here we go. So, get this started. Episode 22. 22. That means it's Tuesday. It's the fourth week of January, and we're looking at the number four songs. Starting off with 1960, Running There by Johnny Preston. Suds Up, pull the sleeves up, we'll get the water going, and we don't have a lot today, so we'll see how far we get. If we're done early, we'll just announce the last song, we'll see if it gets played, so here we go. Turn it up a little bit. So I think this is the first song I ever played for this whole thing. So, it's been there 4 weeks now. Heard a lot. Anyway, here we go. The water feels tepid. Don't seem to be a lot of flow tonight. Put it away. Wash cloth. Green scrubber. And the hot water. Alright, so this week's theme, sweatshirts. So, just a standard white sweatshirt, not a hoodie. There we go. After all, it is the last week of January, and it's chill enough to wear a hoodie, or to wear a sweatshirt. So I'll fill it up about 3/4. You don't have a lot of dishes. I mean, you can look right there, it doesn't look like a lot. But I have a lot in the other basin next to it. So I did some pre-soak. There's already, you can see some dishes. Really good. Not sure if this was washed or not, so we always wash it. There's other things that are washed. Alright. As usual, start with the cups. So that was 1960. January 1960, the number four song for that fourth week. A little funky 1970, got Sly and the Family Stone. Definitely funky. Song, I want to thank you, and then the parenthesis part for Let Me Be Myself is funny because it looks like some kind of mice elf. You'll have to check it out. Look at the notes section on this video, or you can look at the list on other sources I have, Spotify, WordPress. Continue with the what I did yesterday with the 70s. We did the two CCR songs. We were the same with Sly and the Family Stone. We played two in a row. You got that. Janet Jackson took that there. It was part of her Rhythm Nation. Can you hear that? It's a nice little sample. She's on the charts in 1990, January of 1990. 20 years later, that same tune, that same little riff in the background, not the heavy bass up front. I just want to say thank you to Sly and the Family Stone for allowing people to sample music. Share it. Enter into it. Playing on the shoulders of giants. Sometime this week I'll try and do another slicing episode. The missing episode, that Thursday one, is a slicing episode, but there's no audio with it, so maybe someday I'll post it. I have to figure that out. I'll just re-record it. Like I said too, we can do a cooking countdown. It doesn't always have to be washing the dishes, but that's, you know, a good thing. I gotta get them done, so might as well be myself. Yeah, thank you, Sly, the Family Stone. So still January 1970. It's kind of a 2-4, two for Tuesday, right? Huh? Here we go. This one's everybody. Before the countdown's done. So, look forward to the next song. Thank you, Sly, and the Family Stone. Robinson, not you. The song is Cruisin' from January 1980. You have to kind of be quiet though, unless you know the words, okay? January 19th, Smokey Robinson, last week of January.
No, I'm sorry. This isn't the last week of January. Oh my goodness, I'm so mistaken. This is the first week of February. Wow, I got that all wrong. Where is it? No, this would be... No, dog. No. I know you're trying to talk to me, but no. I'm figuring it out. No, I'll figure it out. Let me figure it out. Alright, let's see. Episodes 1 through 5 is January. 6 through 10 is January. 11 through 15. And 16 through 20. Oh, yeah, so this is the first week of February. Good gracious. Woo, I am mistaken. This is week 5. Week 5. All these songs are the 5th week of the year ending in 0. Yeah, no, it's pretty bad there, dogs. My apologies, Suds on the hat. There we go, that's what I deserve. Wow. Yeah, so this is the first week of February, 5th week of the year's ending in 0. Man. Episode 22, and you'd think I'd have this rehearsed or something. Hey, let it go. At least the information on the notes part of the video should be correct. Alright, so where are we at? Oh yeah. So we're moving toward Valentine. Somebody in the background clapping there. Keeping it real, right? There's no fancy production studio. Just me, the dishes. Anybody watching this? And some music. Or what would be considered the best? I mean, I had the top 5 hits. Even if you hit number 4, it's still top 5. So, yeah. The Grammys a little while ago. You can see it. You could have the best selling song of the year and still not get song of the year. I don't understand that. That's why I think the Billboard Music Awards are more accurate. Lil Nas X broke all kinds of records for the number one, being at number one. All summer, spring, that was the number one song. In the top 5 for spring, summer, and fall, and not the song of the year. I don't know. The jury of judges there, that panel, I think they missed it, man. I'm not discrediting Billie Eilish, but come on, man. That's why Billboard 1970s had it, man. That's based on radio airplay and record sales. People's money talk, right? People bought it because they wanted to hear it more than once and hear it on the radio. Song here, it's real. It is the song. I've come up with another system sometimes. People's Choice is not bad. It's not my idea that I'll try and promote this year. I've come up with some kind of an award system. You know, songs, movies, events, things that stood the test of time. Not only were they popular, or missed. Missed at the time they came out, and then became popular later. That's a true, true, true hit. No. Anyway, my point being, got these songs here, the top five, but I think you'll see a little difference when we get to the number five song from 2010. We're cruising together. So 1990, the group Seduction, takes two. For the first week of February. February. Or the fifth week of the music year. There we go. Nifty little IKEA knives. Kind of slowing down here a little bit because I don't have a lot of dishes. And we still have 2000 and 2010 also to go. Could also do a music countdown of me making lunches. You know, getting them ready for the next day at work, school, whatnot. Kind of fun. I don't know what you call that. Lunchbox Daddy. This episode's going to have to be a little shorter. I don't think I'll actually play all the songs, but I'll still put them on the list for those who want to know what the songs are. My apologies to those artists, but we got certain constraints I'm facing here. And I have a life more than just washing dishes. Let me say that. I have a life more than just washing dishes. I've got some other responsibilities I got to get to also. Dishes for next time. We're almost done here. Here we go. Sing it. Yeah, invest, maybe get some viewers here. Some kind of tripod system too. It's a matter of money and time. I'd really like to expand this project. Make it more professional. I might look into some crowdsourcing. I didn't even think of that until just now. That'd be kind of fun. Did some real tools, real lights, real production, real dishes. So here we are. Here's 2000. It's Brian McKnight back at one, although he's at number four. It's week number five, the first week of February. Year 2000. And Brian McKnight is back at one. And I have one dish left. So I don't think we're going to make it through the whole song, but thank you, Mr. McKnight. Which means we're not going to get to Young Money's Bedrock. I don't have an edited version of it anyhow, so probably just as well. Next time we can get to that song. I'll have to find a better version, edited version. It's crazy. Somebody told me that song we started with Johnny Preston's Running Bear. Thought that background with that rhythm, the acapella rhythm on that, would make for a good rap background. We'll see. We'll see if that person follows through with it. Or some kind of song they'd like to use it for. So we'll see. See where that goes. That's it. Suds Up. And we'll leave it at that. And we can thank Mr. McKnight for taking us out. And we'll see you tomorrow for the number three songs for the first week of February, week number five, and years on the end zero. 1973-2010. Have a good night.